Tagging on Redbubble is very important because it's how customers find your work, and therefore how you get sales. The tags you choose are just as important as the design you've uploaded, so I'll explain how you can set yourself up for success by understanding the secrets of Redbubble tags. The tag box used to say up to 50 above it, but Redbubble got rid of it and now suggests using 15. But you can still enter 50. So, what? More tags means more exposure, right? Well, no. Redbubble indicated that if you choose around 15 relevant tags, the algorithm prioritizes your work in the search results as more relevant when compared to people that use 50 tags. In a 2020 article, they confirmed that their search team have implemented a bunch of clever things that mean tag spamming can work against you. It seems that less is more, and you shouldn't purposefully fill up the 50 tag limit just because you can. You might think you'll show up for more search terms, but it can work against you for the important keywords that you want to rank for. My advice is to listen to Redbubble and use around 15 relevant tags. If you happen to have more than 15 relevant tags, then use them, but don't purposefully fill the limit if you don't need to. Don't add product names like t-shirt to your listing because this is automatically added by Redbubble depending on what the customer is looking for, so there's no need for it. And definitely don't try and cheat the system by using tags like best-selling or popular when you upload to try and appear higher in the search results. It doesn't work and Redbubble doesn't like it. When it comes to tagging, do think about your target demographic. Who will your customers be and what will they type in the search box to find your work? If you had one like this, you might decide on ghost, cute, spooky, and Halloween. If you get stuck and can't think of any more, look up synonyms on Google to find alternative words. So you might type ghost synonym to find spectre, phantom, and wraith. Once you've done that, I've got three techniques that you can use to come up with additional tags, as well as a method for vetting them to see whether they're worth using. The first technique involves typing tags that you already came up with into the Redbubble search to get suggestions of popular terms that you can then copy if they're relevant. By searching for ghost, you get recommended pumpkin, skeleton, trick or treat, and creepy. You can use the arrow on the right hand side to see more terms. Your customers will also be presented with the same links to click on, so they're more likely to find you work if you use these tags. The second technique involves looking at the best sellers of your chosen keywords and investigating the tags that they've used. Sort by best selling so you know what's making sales and click the designs that you like. Then scroll to the bottom of the page and you'll see the tags that they've used. The good thing about doing this is that you know for a fact that these designs are selling and customers are finding them through these tags. All of them are hyperlinked so you can just click to investigate further. Hold Ctrl down as you click to open it in a new tab, and if you're on a Mac, you can hold Command and click. You can then repeat the process on the new tags because you'll see new recommended terms at the top and new products to explore as well. The third technique involves using the Merch Titans tag generator, which allows you to generate a list based on a single keyword. This tool takes the top tags from the best-selling products and makes the process easier. However, it's important to bear in mind that just because a tag appears in many of the popular artworks doesn't mean it's a good one for you to use, or that it's possible to compete for that same tag. That's why it's important to vet the tags no matter what technique you use to find them, which is easy to do by looking at how many results there are. The number of results is always displayed here at the top next to the keyword, so you can see how much competition there is for each tag. Is it feasible for you to compete for this tag, or is it worth looking for better ones? The tag girl, for example, has over 2 million results, which makes it a very difficult keyword to rank for. Girl power, however, only has 133,000 results. Therefore, you're much more likely to show up in the search results and make sales for girl power than you are for just girl. Now, you might be wondering, is it better to tag girl, power as individual tags, or girl power as one multi-word tag? According to Redbubble, multi-word tags are fine. Your design will show up for the entire phrase as well as the individual words used. So by adding girl power, your designs will also show up individually for girl and power. If you want an advantage over the competition, you should optimize your listings for search engines like Google. This is often referred to as search engine optimization, or SEO for short. Search engines pick up the information that's in your title, which is here, and description, which is here, in order to display your products to customers outside of Redbubble. People can even search for something on Google and filter by Redbubble designs on the left. Try to use at least the main keyword, if not more, in your title and description. Don't just spam keywords, but write the description in which the words occur naturally. Rather than having the title as Boo, you can use your keyword research from earlier and title your listing Spooky Ghost. You can write a description that uses your keywords too, like, this spooky ghost is a cute addition to your Halloween collection. That way, you'll be displayed by search engines for spooky, ghost, cute, and Halloween. The description box is optional and most people don't bother filling it in, so they'll miss out on extra sales. Redbubble also uses an incredibly annoying but effective type of marketing called behavioural retargeting. This means that if someone checks out your upload, Redbubble pays for advertisements of your product to chase them around the internet using tracking technology. So when they're browsing later on, they get reminded about the design they've seen. This often works in getting them to buy because they keep seeing the design that they've clicked on. It happens if customers come across your design on Redbubble, as well as by searching on Google or other search engines, which is another reason to fill out the title and description with search engines in mind. Also consider spelling and alternative terms when you're tagging because Redbubble is an international site. Customers are ordering from all over the world, and adding an additional spelling for one of your words can result in hundreds of extra sales. Despite English being used by both America and Britain, there are hundreds of spelling variations and you can quickly check them just by searching online. But there's also variations in terminology. For example, Americans say fall, 417,000 results, whereas Brits say autumn, 352,000 results. Adding just one extra keyword can give you access to a massive audience that otherwise you would have missed out on. This is just one example, but there's hundreds of them, and it gets even more complicated when you add other English-speaking countries like Australia and New Zealand. The point is, whatever terms that you plan on using, just do a quick search to see if other parts of the world spell it or say it differently, because it can result in so many more sales. I hope this video was helpful for you, and if it was, subscribe to my channel for more useful tips. I recommend that you learn about the popular tags tool next, which shows you the top 10,000 tags on Redbubble. I'll see you soon with more content.